his life to all the world. Instruct me now and inspire with words, colors. The chaos and the hell of Earth's ancient past. Take me back to life's beginning, shrouded in sulphurous mist. Oxygenless, treeless, flowerless past, O cells, sing within me of your first youth. I see you trapped in the rocks there in Africa. Thou Swaziland microbial mats, which tell the story for all who dare to read it. The story of a boiling Hades. 3.5 billion years ago, O Earth, accept me as your humble publicist. And let me sing of ribosomes and mito. Chondria and things not yet immortalized in music, prose, or rhyme. Teach me, O ancient nine, honored muses, come. Sing for my senses with the nine microtubules. Teach me how God copulated with chaos and from that vast and dark abyss created this fine world. Sing to me of how that bubble formed in that esoteric chemistry and made life and made me from that first moment. Oh, did it all begin, Great Spirit? Was it a system of interlocking reactions that persist and repeat and then repeat again and then repeat again? An octopodic system or cyclical series of interlocking reactions like some inevitable chemical clock? Oh, Spirit Muse, reveal the inner workings of your heart and greasy bubble world. Grandfather Sun, who warms us and touches our hearts and lights the world, send his impregnating solar kindness to that mother drop. Solar inspiration flowing through her maiden limbs and vivifies us. Teach she by constant interchange of parts with sister bubbles maintain herself. Hegelians take note, self coming to know itself through creation and a metamonad is born. Our shrewd ancestor. Mom, is that you? Our self-maintaining greasy membrane, 3.5 billion years old. And how did this greasy cell get legs? How in that tract of hell, the Hadean Precambrian world, how did our grandmother cell taste first a child of union with the oven? What made her do it? How was it ever that happy state of single selfhood? She was, after all, queen of the world. Complete, without the agony of death or aging. Thermoplast had no nucleus, it's true, but so what? She was fat, happy, single, and rich. Say, who first seduced her? She who had everything. Well, there was another bacteria this time, crawling through the combustion, fire, and poison of incredibly hot, smelly, and horrible Hadean times. He was the ancestor of what we now call spirochete. A wild wriggler, an unmistakably snaky thing, and there he was, slithering in the fiery soup with nowhere to go and nothing to do. Earth, 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 early Earth, in dark Precambrian times. Who was a furnace of sorrow, no flowers, no happy sunny lawns, no Sundays, no artist colonies, no downtown lake falls, no nothing, just burning sulfur, volcanoes, rocks, and that was Earth. Out of darkness, the snaky one was crawling. He and his creepy pals, snaking through the Swaziland scum, looking for something to do. Some way to get out of suburbia and into the glamorous kingdom of animals. But they had no car. Once they had lived in heaven, like princes. But now, the Spirochete, having offended the Great Spirit with his arrogance, had been condemned to Earth. Prison. It was torture. And the priest Spirochete broke the ghastly silence with these words. He said, if I can get over on this mother egg, this beautiful fat monad, if I can just get up inside her, I will be able to reproduce myself and make the world my own. It may take a while, but eventually I'll be back on top, driving a Ferrari and acting like God, drinking beer and playing the trombone or some such instrument as I used to play in heaven. So he slithered up to the Mother Monad. He made a few dumb comments and tried to touch her butt, but she didn't even look at him. Wild wriggler, hungry, desperate, was not a quitter. He invaded the egg, got his head in, and once he got in, his head got stuck. He couldn't get out, and Mom turned the tables on him. She clapped down and put him to work. And this was the beginning of nucleated cells. From this merger of thermoplast mom and snake-like modal factor, new cells emerged, enlarged. The molten fireball Earth was cooling now, and clouds of steam and mist rose up. Obscuring the sun from sight. Still the bacteria grew and divided and grew. And then the rain began to fall, a hot rain, torrential, for 1,000 years. Still the bacteria did their subtle work, not by conquest or competition as good Darwin thought, but by means more charming. Vast networks arose, a global communication network 1,000,000,000 years old, horizontal exchange of information, cell to cell, exchange of ideas, gracious mutuality. Bacteria share what they know, and what belongs to one belongs to all. And this had made the kingdom of bacteria omnipotent. And we try to conquer them with our smarty pants antibiotics. Within a year or two, they get around it. No big deal, for the world's bacteria have access to a single gene pool. And through this sharing and unified enjoyment of cooperation, they make composite creatures, reveling in novelty. Artist bacterium, and the bacteria cover the earth in an intricate symbiotic web, a mind without a brain, cognitive, absolutely regulating the chemical oxygen production and the carbon dioxide production of this living system, Earth. And after Monera, what visible plant or animal appeared first? I hear you asking with one voice. Well, baby, it's neither plant nor animal. Because just in, a fax from Morgan's cousin, a fax from Science Magazine, August 2001, it says fungi came first! 800 million years ago, fungi. Hello! The first bacterial invention was fermentation. Thank you, I'll take a Heineken. Fungi, shrooms, soba, chemical eaters, descendants of chytrids, nitrogen fixers, arbuscular mycorrhizae still in the roots of every tree, working together and sharing. Get the picture? There was a tremendous amount of oxygen around, waste. of a hydrogen eating going on, and it was toxic to bacteria. It killed them. But bright bacteria got the idea. Why not eat oxygen? Around this time, Pangaea was breaking up, and India was drifting up toward the Himalayas for a mystic rendezvous. New Jersey was playing footsie with Morocco and so forth, but soon the continents found their balanced places. And if those damn volcanoes would just stop going off for a minute, maybe we could get some life going on around here anyways. The thousand-year reign came. And came, and came, and came, and came into the oceans where animals first emerged. In Australia, of course, in the southwest, as every Abenaki Indian can tell you. First came jellyfish and worms, and next fish. Oh, oh, from the fish, a creature with the muzzle in front. Lungs evolved. You can see it at the American Museum of Natural History. Doesn't anyone ever dust around there? It's in a case to the left of the door, in the Precambrian room. Hell, it scared the bejesus out of me. It's a frog as big as a dog. A frog with jaws and huge fangs. Not a pretty sight, let me tell you, but it's our common ancestor, as I shall reveal. For from this amphibian who crawled out came reptiles, snakes, crawling bellies, and salamanders, newts, and lizards. They were egg layers, nest builders, and remember, all this movement is still coming from that magic seed at the base of all life, spirochete, who became flagellum and then unduly podium. The corkscrew Archibacterium is at the root of every central kinetosome. Remember the protein microtubule with the 9 × 3+0 array? Some spinning muses threads now. Axons and dendrites. How we move and think. And his eons, epics, and eras of creativity never ceasing. But sometimes, in a fit and fury, he wipes out everything and starts again. More brilliantly, more beautifully. Amazing diversity, interconnected global networks invented by bacteria. Gene splicing, cloning, DNA recombination, the internet, all invented billions of years ago by a thing with no brain. Bacteria! And off to the big Cambrian die-off. Outstanding creativity, with originality, with balls, life grew again. And now from lizards grew Satan's progeny, the dinosaurs. Big, loud, ugly, macho! About this time, the Great Spirit was watching from his crystal throne! Watching on a very wide screen top of TV, which they have in heaven. He watched the dinos for a while and liked him, but then he thought, this is really over the top. And it could cause trouble later on if I decide to bump up the brain power. So he said, boys, Tyrannosaurus, Raptor, Bronto, you want to play hardball? And he threw a gigantic meteor at the Earth. Yep, a giant spitball right over home plate. Strike three, and it was 7 miles across. Cretaceous tertiary extinction wiped him out. The magnetic poles reversed. It was back to the drawing board. And from the steaming pool of muck and stark volcanic night came crawling new creatures, evolved dominating desire and lover's cruel pangs. Folks, stay with me, stay with me. I realize it's not too ladylike to sing a song about this topic, but once the story has begun, it's hard to stop. Mammals are descended from, drumroll please, rats! Yep, mammals from rats. And good things sometimes come in small packages. This ushered in the age of mammary glands. Millions of years of Earth history went into the making of breasts, and it was worth the wait, wasn't it, boys? Glorified sweat glands. Yes, warm-blooded vertebrates came from reptiles and also birds. Those angelic singers. Most of the autobiography of the world. So look up. Look up into the trees. The trees were created by fungus, algae, and bacteria. Look up. See the first prosimians, a kind of lemur with big eyes for night vision on the front of their heads. Eventually, the simians came home from the earth to look for more food, and they went over. The savannah of East Africa. She stood up to look for enemies. Selection favored those who stood up straight. And so, from the selective advantage of this upright position, came the chimp. Hands free. Now she took hold of a stick to defend herself. Or a stick to dig for yummy things to eat. Stimulated brain growth. Her name? Homo afarensis. From a little village in Ethiopia called Afar, where all the women are beautiful. And this is Lucy, our common mother. From this beautiful woman, smart, upright, brave, a survivor, came all the women in the world. With that strange spiral heat at the root of all of Lucy's moving centriole, kinetosomes, brain cells, hands and feet, that stick is out. It's true, but perhaps this strange and screwy snake has learned at last. From a billion years of suffering in hell, perhaps the vainglorious architect, once kicked over the crystal gates of heaven by a furious god, has learned his lesson at long last. At long last, the devil has learned to love. From the bacteria, he has learned cooperation, how to share. Look at the vast communities of the microcosmos, like the ones from which we are made. Look outside at the earth, this superorganism, this self-regulating beautiful community, this geosphere, biosphere, atmosphere, hydrosphere, a vast global network, interdependent, creative, cognitive, sensitive. Depress you with more numbers. Music should uplift and inspire. But do read up and you will find we are in the midst of the sixth great extinction. But Earth will survive, my friends. She is tough. Her great catastrophes and disasters just make her stronger, more creative, more brilliant. It may take 25 million years to get over what men have done. It may take 25 million years. and it's well underway. But Mob will make it. As long as that sun keeps shining, the Great Mother will keep making new and wonderful things. Thank you, Great Spirit, for giving me eyes to see this beauty, ears to hear this beauty, and a tongue to sing my thanks and praise to the generous genius who made it all. And from this came chemicals like carbon and hydrogen. The chemicals began speaking to each other in their language of chemistry, and out of the rocks, from their conversations and creative collaborations, came bacteria, which likewise invented great things like fermentation, photosynthesis, and oxygen. And from this came the oceans and the lovely blue sky, and the air, and the fungi, and the algae got together to make lichens who broke up the rocks and made the fertile soil. Plants and animals co-evolved, each sharing and helping each other, sharing their gifts, and mutually co-creating, and from this interdependence came fish, amphibians, reptiles, dinosaurs, birds, mammals, and man. 5 magic kingdoms. And so do unto others as you would have them do unto you, because they are you. Remember, Satan was God's architect in heaven, a cunning builder, a glory monger, a builder, one who knows how to put things together with the golden section. Fractals, Julia sets, complex numbers, Mandelbrot sets. He knew the square root of -1, and any other number you might name. Satan was an engineer, an architect, an artist. Let me spell it out for you. First, the spirochete corkscrew bacterium and thermoplast got together in a composite. Sulfur eater and heat lover joined, and next they convinced a lighting designer to come along, for everyone in show business knows the importance of a good lighting designer. This was coccoid cyanobacteria, a chloroplast, expert in photosynthesis. And finally, because oxygen was all around them, somebody said, "How about opening a window? I need some air." And they added the ancestor of mitochondria. And then the 4 lived at one. And all life on Earth today, inhabitants of cities, forests, jungles, oceans, tall grass prairies, artists, mathematicians, porn stars, priests, dung beetles, whales, dolphins, sharks, fireflies, beetles, trombone players, lonely women, kitty cats, doggies, rats, directors of foundations, stars of the prairie, and sweet strawberries at the gate, using us to spread their seeds. All are descendants and progeny of that ancient bacterium from 3,000 million years ago. And bacteria never die. They just exchange parts and go on. Only those of us born from sex die. And every one of you is a massive colony of microorganisms, former monad protists, all from this common ancestor who has transformed herself into eloquently orchestrated plants and animals with fancy tissues. And so do the math, my friends, and you will see. You should be kind to one another, for we are family.